Let's illustrate the use of contact stress formulae with a numerical problem. In this problem, we have been given that a carbon steel ball of 25 mm diameter is pressed against a flat carbon steel plate. So we have a flat plate by a force of 18 newtons. The material properties, both the material of ball as well as the plate, are carbon steel, and the properties of carbon steel are given in the problem. What we have to calculate are the principal stresses at the contact area. So at the center of contact region, we have to calculate what are the principal stresses. The principal stresses are nothing but the values of sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, because at this point the shear stress is zero. So those three stress components themselves are the principal stresses. Second, you have to calculate the maximum shear stress at contact area. So at this same location, you have to calculate what is the maximum shear stress. And the last part asks the maximum shear stress occurring inside the thickness of the plate. So as we have seen previously, as we move towards the inside of the second body, the maximum shear stress initially increases, it peaks and then it drops down. So we have to find out the peak value of the maximum shear stress below the surface. So that is what is asked in the third part of the problem. So let's start solving this problem. So just to make it clear, we are having a ball of 25 millimeter diameter subjected to 18 newton force and pressed against a carbon steel plate. So the first part is calculation of principal stress. Principal stresses. For this purpose, we have to find out what is the size of contact region, which is given by the formula as 3F by A 1 minus nu square by nu 1 square by E 1 plus 1 minus nu 2 square by E 2 divided by 1 by D 1 plus 1 by D 2. By substituting the values, we will get this expression as cube root of 3 multiplied by 18 newtons divided by 8 in the bracket 1 minus 0.3 square divided by the value is 207 GPa, that is 207 into 10 to power 3 MPa. And since both materials are carbon steel, the numerator part will be duplicated. On the denominator, we are having the first D1 is 25 millimeter and the second D2 is infinity since it is a flat plate. So we get the value of A as 0.1141 millimeters. Now based on this value of A, we can now calculate what is the maximum value of contact pressure, which is given as 3 by 2 F divided by pi a square. By substituting the values, we will get 3 by 2 into 18 divided by pi multiplied by 0.1141 square. So this amounts to 660.15 newton per millimeter square. So we have got the value of contact pressure. Next, we will calculate the value of sigma x, sigma y, sigma z in terms of P max. So the value of sigma x and sigma y are identical and they are given by the expression, which is minus P max in the bracket 1 minus z by 8 tan inverse 1 by z by a 2 1 plus nu minus 1 divided by 2 times 1 plus z square by a square. Note that in this case, we are calculating at the contact region on the surface. So that implies that z is equal to 0, which simplifies these expressions, and we can calculate sigma x and sigma y as minus 660.15 in the bracket 1 minus 0, 1 plus 0.3 minus 1 by 2 in bracket 1 plus 0. So it gives us the value of sigma x and sigma y as minus 528.12 Newton per mm square. We can calculate sigma z. We did not calculate sigma z because that is nothing but the value of contact pressure. The negative sign is for the compressive stress. So this is nothing but 660.15 Newton per mm square. So that is the end of first part of the problem, where we have to calculate the principal stresses at this particular region. Now let's calculate the maximum shear stress in this region. So that is the second part, the maximum shear stress at surface. The maximum shear stress in the case of three-dimensional situation is defined as tau max equal to max of sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2, sigma 2 minus sigma 3 by 2, and sigma 3 minus sigma 1 by 2. In this particular case, sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma 3 are nothing but our values of sigma x, sigma y, sigma z, and the tau max can be obtained as minus 528.12 minus of minus 160.15 divided by 2, and that gives us the answer as 66.02 Newton per millimeter square. So that is the answer for the second part. Now the last part is calculating what is the maximum shear stress below the surface. So that is third part, maximum shear stress below the surface. If you refer to the previous slide, you will find that the maximum shear stress, it occurs at z by a equal to 0.5, and tau max is given as 0.31 times p max. So we'll use this for evaluating or for answering the third part of the problem. So we are having tau max below surface is given as 0.31 times P max, and the location is at z by a equal to 0.5. So note that this particular relationship, that is the proportion of the stress and the location, you will have to remember. Those will not be available to you during the evaluation. So in this case, the maximum stress can simply be calculated as 0.31 times 660.15, that is 204.65 Newton per mm square. So that is the answer for the third part of the problem. As you can see here, that this particular value 204.65 is larger than what we calculated on the surface, that is 66.02. Let's summarize this session. We have seen that under the application of load, the initial point contact between the spheres or the line contact between the cylinders becomes a finite area due to the deformation of contacting bodies. The contact stress calculations initially obtain the size of this contact region based on theory developed by Heinrich Hertz. The maximum stress, that is the maximum contact stress, occurs at the middle of this contact region. However, the maximum shear stress occurs at a finite depth below the contacting surface from where the damaging crack begins. I thank you for your time and attention. Goodbye everyone, and see you in the next session.